Here are the stories for the day. Varun Ravindra had always been passionate about conserving the environment and the forests. So he started Vanantra to revive over 100 acres of barren land and make it sustainable. His dream was to be able to help conserve the environment, create a habitat for a variety of life and help alleviate the global warming. In 2016, he founded Vanantra by buying 100 acres of land near the Karnataka-Tamil Nadu border, which now has over 40,000 trees across over 250 species of trees. Along with the team, he first forested the land and then invited like-minded members to be part of this community and movement. Collectively, they created a forest ecosystem at Vanantra with size, scale and benefits that would not have been possible individually. The work at Vanantra primarily revolves around soil remediation and creating the right environment for a variety of biodiversity to thrive. After decades of heavy usage of chemical fertilizers and pesticides, most soils are now inert. The activities at Vanantra include composting, vermicomposting, preparation of fermented bio inputs such as Jivamrut, infusing soil with efficient microorganisms and using foliar sprays that serve as growth enhancers. Orgin Panstong of Leh is growing 20 varieties of organic crops ranging from barley to watermelons at 14,000 feet. Orgin Panstong, popularly known as Mitti Ka Aadmi in the village, has been successfully following an integrated farming system approach at a height of 14,000 feet, where it is difficult for even human beings to survive. He's producing different vegetables, growing cereals like barley, raising livestock, cultivating mushrooms, rearing sheep and goats, and producing vermicompost from his farm, animal and household waste. A key feature of his farming system is that he uses the output of one component as input of another component, thereby reducing his cost of cultivation and raising his income. Chana Pal from Kolkata is keeping alive the age-old tradition of modeling goddess Durga. It wasn't easy for Chana to challenge the prevalent male dogma of the society and make a niche of her own. When she entered the shop, her first challenge was to learn the art and create a customer base which she knew would be lost after her father passed. Despite being a newcomer in the profession, she now holds the title of Dhash Bhuja, one with 10 hands, for her incredible agility in handling both her studio and her house at the same time. Last year, she made an unusual Durga idol, Ardhanarishwar, an androgynous sculpture of the transgender community, one of the first such idols in India. Everyone has the right to pray and preach, and so does the transgender community. When they requested me to make, how could I have refused? She said.